Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it.
I can't escape it, can I? I have to go through with it, don't I? Alright, here we go. The Star Wars Holiday Special.
Believe it or not, I actually have a copy of the screenplay right here. Let's see what it says.
Do something!
Whip, whip, stir, beat, stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir, stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir, stir, whip, 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 stir, stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir.
Was packed under.
Were there other scripts that just got mixed in with this one? Just stick to one fucking premise so we can get this over with! God! God, I need booze. We're then seen inside a room with, oh Jesus, more screeching Wookiees. Robes! Is it a Wookiee chorus? Are they gonna sing Christmas carols? No, no, don't do it, don't do it!
Don't worry, Critic! I'll save you!
Wow! Thanks, Santa Christ!
Not at all, Critic! Now, hold still!
What'd you do?
I just cured your diabetes!
I have diabetes? I didn't even know I had diabetes!
Oh, you don't know? And now, as a special gift, I'm going to wipe your mind clean of this horrible holiday special!
It worked! I don't even remember what we were talking about!
Indeed! Alrighty then, Critic! Now, Santa Christ has to get back on my rocket ship!
Santa Christ is a rocket ship?
Oh, and a Harley!
Oh, you kick ass!
I know!
You're just so gosh darn wonderful. I love you, Santa Christ.
Santa Christ, Santa Christ, we all love Santa Christ. He is Santa and Jesus, goddamn it, Santa Christ.
Jesus H. Jesus, can we just get somebody with some goddamn emotion? Because that's what Christmas is. That's what Christmas is. You got it, special. You fucking got it. No. No, you didn't. And that's why this is the word special. I'll tell you why. Because Christmas is not about that. It's not about that dumbass little message you was trying to throw in at the last minute. You know what? It's not even really about giving or sharing or love or anything about that. That's a part of it, but there's something even more important. You want to know what it is? I'll tell you what Christmas is. Christmas is effort. It's putting effort into that kindness. It's putting effort into that sharing. It's putting effort into that loving. Because anyone can just give something. Anyone can just buy something, whether it costs $1 million if you're rich or nothing if you're poor. But by God, it's the effort you put into it. If you got something someone really wanted, then that's effort. Or if you made something that somebody didn't even know they wanted, that's effort. That's loving. It's putting the effort into that stuff. And that's something that's clearly not in this special. They just slapped it together, didn't give a shit. And you can't do that on Christmas, man. You have to try. You have to try to make this stuff good, because that is what we're trying to do. It's about putting effort in something that's even bigger than yourself. Because when somebody comes up to me and wishes me a holiday from a religion maybe I don't celebrate, if somebody said Happy Hanukkah to me, I'd wish Merry Christmas back. You know what? We'd be fine with it. You want to know why? Because we're both sharing something that we believe is bigger than ourselves. That is putting effort into that. That is celebrating something that's wonderful and loving and unbelievable. It's putting that effort into Christmas, into sharing something so great and fantastic. Let me show you something. Follow me, Mr. Cameron. Follow me. You know, it is all about effort, because that is what we're trying to do here. We're trying to all come together so that we can celebrate and put that effort into everything that is good with the world. Like these people right here. Look at how much effort these people put in all the time. Unbelievable. Come here, you guys. These are people that work behind the scenes, in front of the scenes, all of a sudden they do such a good job. Guys, you've been doing so great. You got that guy with the glasses audience watching right now. Is there anything you would like to say to him this Christmas Eve?
God bless us, everyone.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Potter.
How about you? You got a movie quote?
Not really, but as we approach the new year, just know that we always want to get better and don't get drunk.
See, that's effort. Whether it be just a movie quote that means a lot to them or, you know, something very sincere, that's effort. I love you guys. You guys are awesome. But it doesn't stop there, because we keep going out here showing more of the effort, more of the... It's about this guy. Christmas is about this guy right here. That's right, the cameraman, my brother Rob. He's been working so hard. Hey, 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 no, stand up, come on. You've been working so hard. You got everybody watching it right now. Anything you want to wish people this Christmas?
Merry Christmas?
Oh, come on, you do better than that, come on.
And, Happy New Year.
Come on, bigger than that.
You filthy animal.
Oh, for God's sake, you can't think of anything better to say on Christmas Eve?
Okay, fine, it's... You know, it's a little hard to get into the Christmas spirit with the way it's been over-commercialized and stuff, but really when you think deep about it, it's Christmas is not just a bunch of things that you buy, it's about an attitude, a spirit, something you carry with you in your heart when 2,000 years ago a man was born into a stable, not adorned with gifts and presents and stuff and trees, but born into poverty. And you see that every day when a child does something nice for his grandma, or when, you know, we give things to homeless people. You know, it's something that lasts, that endures and goes on and on till the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust.
Okay, okay, take the camera, Okay. It's about believing in something bigger than yourself, like I said, and putting that effort into it, because you don't have to believe in Christianity or Catholicism or any of that stuff. You don't have to be any religion. You just have to believe in humanity, and that's what's so great about. It's believing in the best of humanity and the effort it puts into that bestness. It's about these two. This is my mom and dad. They put so much effort into raising me, because they are so awesome that way. This guy joined the Navy so he could help support and raise us, and my mom, she was gonna be an opera singer. But she had two kids and said, you know what, I'm gonna spend my life dedicated to that. And that is so unbelievable, and that is Christmas. There's such goodness. There's such goodness in these people. So, Dad, you got so many people watching right now. Is there anything you wanna say to the That Guy with Glasses audience on Christmas Eve here?
Merry Christmas to all of you. And most importantly, remember, we have lots of merchandise in the Channel Awesome Country Store. 15% off of your name, Ryan Finn Walker.
It's going to be really... That's the kind of ham he is. That's the kind of guy that my dad is. You can see where I got my terrible sense of humor. But nonetheless, he has spent... But nonetheless, he has worked so hard to raise us. And he has just been so positive, so upbeat. And I love my dad. And Mom, I got a question for you. It's a question I really wanted to say for you, because you're so loving and you're so heartfelt and everything. There's a lot of people out there who don't associate Christmas with the best stuff. Maybe they don't have many friends or much family, and maybe they're spending it alone, or maybe they associate it with a bad time. There's so many bad things that happen out there, and Christmas is such a good time. And I know you feel it. You feel like I feel it. What can you say to people out there who are not having such a good Christmas?
You know, this is the time of year to reach out to someone else who is lonely or is having a hard time and do something nice for them, because when you do that, you will feel less lonely inside of yourself as well. It's a perfect time of year to do something for somebody else and think of others.
That's really nice, Mom. Thanks so much. This movie sucks balls, but I love you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Thanks so much, guys. Merry Christmas to you.
Who the hell was that?
Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it so you don't have to. Well, Christmas is over, Santa has come, and I guess I got a little bit of the post-Christmas blues. I mean, 12 months waiting, weeks upon weeks of hoping for the world's greatest Christmas gifts, and what did I get? A Nintendo Wii Entertainment System, two fully functional controllers, the latest addition to Super Smash Bros. Brawl, and no Mario Kart. Suck my candy cane, Santa! That was the cream of the Yuletide crop, and you knew it! Instead, what did I get in my stocking? A holly jolly dose of bullshit known as Jingle All the Way. The first, and thank God, only Christmas film to star international punchline Arnold Schwarzenegger. And since I got the post-Christmas blues, you're gonna share this hunk of stinking yellow snow with me. So, grab your vomit bags and get ready to find out oh what fun it is to ride in a horseshit-spewing fuck ride like this one. Let's take a look. Nick Lloyd, where do I know that name? My God, what a tall building!
Welcome to me, Jamie, or I will destroy you! Blah!
Uh-oh, how's Arnold gonna get out of this one? Will he have time to get the gift, or will the most unpractical and unplausible of hijinks ensue? Tune in next time when Masterpiece of Shit Theater continues.
That's the Arnold we all know and love! Now squash their heads like grapefruit! Pussy!
I will destroy you, cowboy! You stay away from my wife, or I'll eat you! Cookies! Fuck Booster! Give me the Turbo Man, you girly man! Destroy him! Destroy him, then eat him! Out of my way, children, or I eat you! I eat you all!
Idiots!
Dear God, my son is going to grow up to be an unsuccessful, unfunny black man!
That's actually kind of funny. This movie actually had a funny moment in it. Look! I'm smiling! I'm actually smiling! This movie actually had a really funny scene!
How many years in the bomb squad?
No, you're ruining the joke! Don't ruin the one funny scene you have in this movie! You did it! You actually did it! You ruined the only funny joke in the movie, you jingle balls of ass!
Damn you! Damn you all to hell!
Oh, good. What do you think the big witty Schwarzenegger line is gonna be?
You started it.
What? That's all you got? Come on, you're Arnold Schwarzenegger! You're a professional at this! Come on, there's a million better witty lines you could say, like...
No more reindeer games.
Or,
hasta la vista, Rudolph.
Or, if you're really desperate,
I'll be Buck.
Just show us that you're trying. So they show up to the parade of the only affordable copyright characters they could get where, well, I'm not gonna fall for it. Nope. I'm betting you anything that this is not the end of the movie.
Fuck you, movie! Fuck you, fucking!
That's right, Jamie! Kick him in the balls! They are man's greatest design flaw!
Is there a name for what's wrong with these writers?
Okay, alright. Ladies and gentlemen, the film just gave up. It clearly doesn't care about the story narrative or making any semblance of logical sense, so they just said, fuck it, and started showing amusing images that will hopefully entertain your kids. Well, you know what they say, if you can't beat them, join them.
Play me, come on and play with me, and bring your dolly free, climb up my apple tree, look down my rain barrel, slide down my cellar door, help me be jolly then, play me, I cannot play with you, my dolly has the blues. He's got a rain barrel, he's got a cellar door, but will he jolly face,
Jimmy, no, I will have no one to eat for later.
Well, maybe one thing.
Jingle all the way can jingle all the way to hell! This is the worst Christmas gift since Donald Trump's toupee!
Boy.
So you start off in the amusement park, and the first thing you notice is the sign behind you. No vibes, no beavas, no beavas, no vibes.
Oh boy, we're in trouble.
Not only does this not make any sense, but you notice that all the letters are capitalized except for the letter B? Why the fuck is that?
Wait a minute, I just realized something.
Beavis has the same number of letters as Vibes. In fact, it has all the same letters. Vibes is actually an anagram for Beavis. So much so that they don't even capitalize the B when they rewrite it. And the pattern is always one Vibes, two Beavises, never one Beavis and two Vibes. So if Vibes is an anagram for Beavis, Beavis is an anagram for Vibes, and they always come in the order 1-2-1-2, that means... absolutely nothing! I just wasted 5 minutes on this game and I haven't even pushed a button yet!
There's a time limit? I can eat my way through a wall faster than I can defeat these assholes, and there's a time limit!
God! Hey! God!
If a bookcase opens up, it spins around in a circle. So that means that there can only be one room, because if there's a wall separating the two rooms, the bookcase wouldn't open! So how can it lead to two separate rooms? It can't, babies, kids! It just can't! Fred, I knew it! I knew I could do it! I knew I could pull it off! This is gonna get rid of me, angry video game nerd, you are much mistaken. Sure, I will need years of psychological therapy to recover from this, but that doesn't mean you've heard the last of me. All I can say, angry video game nerd, is fuck this game and fuck you for making me play it.
Easy, angry video game.
Oh, shut up!
Critic.
Okay, here's the thing. The game really is innovative and beautiful. Nothing had ever been done like it before.
But it's friggin' hard!
It's a glowy thing! How am I supposed to not go after a glowy thing in a game? It's a glowy thing! It's like telling a dog not to go after a bone! It's friggin' nature! Oh, we're back here again. Okay, use the sword only once. Ha! You're my bitch, purple peen eye! That was two glowy things! You just got in my head not to even go after one glowy thing and then you give me fucking two?! That's like telling me not to go after a cupcake, and then you give me two cupcakes, and then you smack me in the face for not going after the two cupcakes! What do you want? In the depths of your ignorance, what do you want?
The Nostalgic Critic's Top 11 Death Scene.
I'm not giving you the pleasure!
Number 11. Number 10.
Christ.
Number 9.
Gonna make it this time.
Number 8.
I almost had that!
Number 7.
Dirty little...
Number 6.
You're not funny, you know!
Number 5.
I don't even...
Hey!
Number 4.
My pain will not sustain you!
Number 3.
What even happened?
Number 2. And the number 1 Nostalgic Critic Death...
will not be taking place because I just got to the final level! Wow. It's like... the extended cruelty of the first game is condensed down into one single solitary fuck you moment. Well, guess what, fuck you moment? Fuck you! Oh, I literally lost all my happily ever after!
And that is the number one Nostalgic Critic death scene.
These games are a pain! They're beautiful and amazing to look at, but they're a goddamn pain!
Wow, I wonder what it could be. God, this is gonna keep me awake all night. I'm gonna see the movie right now just to find out.
Ha!
Holy crap, was that stupid! So what? Aliens invented the pyramids? Are you nuts? Yeah, all those Egyptian morons with their brilliant groundbreaking designs, they had nothing to do with it. It was just aliens.
And the ruler of the known universe is that chick with the dick from the Crying Game?
Blow me! It's the last time I ever watch a movie by these jokers again. Say, you remember in 1996 when Independence Day came out? It was done by the same idiots who did Stargate, but look, all it showed in the advertising was the White House getting blown up. That's it. Nothing else. Whoa, how the hell does that happen? This movie must be good! I mean, sure they messed up with Stargate, but maybe this'll be a good one. Besides, I've just gotta know how the White House blows up. I'm gonna go check it out right now! Son of a bitch! This movie's even worse than the last one! So what? The President of the United States gets in a jet to fight off aliens? Are you high? God, that's it. I'm done. I am never watching another movie by these morons ever again. Ever. Nope, nope, not interested. No.
I got a bite.
No, I don't care. So even though the filmmakers made two horrible movies before, Godzilla hooked us all in with its clever advertising. How? Because they never showed the monster. You had to see the movie in order to see the monster. So advertisers thought up the brilliant strategy of describing the monster for us. Like vehicles that said his foot is as long as this bus, or billboards that said his head is as big as this sign. It was downright genius. Alright guys, so you suckered us in yet again. But please, please, can you try and give us a good movie this time? I mean, it's Godzilla! It can't be that difficult to make something that's just so unentertaining. Oh, you shitknockers! You did it! You actually did it! You made Godzilla even less credible than it already was! Somebody give these douchebags an award for sucking! Ass! Come on, Gary Oldman, you're a great actor! Why were you choosing these obvious villain roles at the time? I mean, there's just nothing subtle about them.
Did somebody question my subtle acting?
Oh, come on, Dr. Smith, you're about as subtle as a fucking train wreck. On a boat.
Oh, come now, there are several differences between me and that Rupert fellow. For example, I want to seize power and control through a legion of spiders.
But that Rupert guy wants to seize power and control too.
But not with spiders.
Oh, for God's sake. You know what you need to do, Dr. Smith?
Does it involve spiders?
No, you need to be diabolical. Actually fool people into thinking you're a kind, gentle, caring person. You think you can do that?
I think the boat sort of sailed on that one.
All right, well don't bother me anymore. I got a review to do.
Wait, there's one more important thing. It's imperative that you must know.
What? What?
Spiders. Ah! You're doomed. Doomed. Ah!
Explain, movie! Explain! Are those really the images that come to your mind when you hear this song? If so, then you are fucked! Shut up! Does everybody have to sing in this movie?
Just X!
Right now. And not only do I want an answer, I want answered as the most innocent, perfect being that I can think of, Mary Poppins. That's right. Mary Poppins is gonna be my representation of this movie. So tell me, Mary Poppins, how do you explain this bullshit that we just witnessed?
First of all, I would like to make one thing quite clear.
Huh?
I never explain anything.
Fuck you, bitch! Oh my God! Oh my God, I just killed Mary Poppins! I just killed my first childhood icon! Good lord, that's what this movie has done to me! Oh,
twins.
Birds! Oh no, I killed Bert too. Okay, I gotta get out of here before I start killing any more innocent Disney characters. I'm the Nostalgia Critic, I remember it, so you don't have to.
Oh, hi, Mr. Nostalgia Critic.
Oh! Mickey! Oh no! I'm sorry! Quest for Camelot made me do it!
I understand.
No!
Where was I the last 2 minutes? You know, dick. Because that's what you are, fucking dick. When you show this image of the American flag destroyed, you're not just showing your dollar store symbolism that says, ooh, America's hurt. But it's very clear that what is important to you is not how you view America. What is important to you is how others see you viewing America. So, you can make up whatever you want. You can fabricate things. You can lie about history. You can exaggerate. You can glorify. You can demonize. You can distort the facts. You can make up the truth. Make up the truth about people who lost their lives in this great tragedy. Why? Because you're doing it in the name that you fucking love America. I'm sorry, I don't fuck around with this shit. I don't, okay? These are people who have lost their lives, people who have been drafted, people who volunteered, people putting their asses on the line, and many of them don't come back. You're taking it upon yourself to show that. And I know what you're thinking. Yeah, you're thinking, well, I'll just make up people because they weren't really there, so I can do whatever I want with them. I can make shit up. And granted, you don't deserve the responsibility to show real events. You don't live in the real world. But what happens is that when you take it and base it on a real event and you have to show these real people, you have to get it right, Michael Bay. You have to get it right because this isn't Transformers, okay? That's kid shit. You can do whatever you want. It's not The Rock. It's not Chuck Humphrey saying, winners fuck the prom queen. No, it's fucking Pearl Harbor. Reality. It actually happened. And I know you're thinking, well, it's Hollywood. We take liberties. Fuck you. It's not Hollywood. When you take it upon yourself to represent something that really happened and is still painful and hurts a lot of people, that means you have to do two things. One, you have to grow up and be an adult. Two, you have to actually represent these people as best as humanly possible, you son of a bitch! Pronunciation.
It's about, you socially polite freaks! It's about A-B-O-U-T, not A-B-O-O-T! Stop saying a boot! This is a boot! That is a boat! A boot, about, a boot, about, a boot, about! Get it right!
What moron wrote this? Oh, clearly these idiots have no idea how to write an adult scary story. Well, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna write the one for grown-ups, okay? let me see here. Oh, I know. How about Crane was the mastermind the whole time? And he turns into this giant evil monster. And he makes all the scary faces. And then all the little Casper ghosts are like,
so many
complex issues here. All right, and then we're gonna see Eleanor literally, literally defeat him with the power of love. Oh, it's so inspired. It's so ingenious. Hey, I don't care if it was laughed off at the Disney afternoon. I'm the adult. I'm the adult. I write adult thing. That's stupid. That's stupid psychological issue. Oh, yes. I'm the adult. I write the adult thing. You're dumb. You're dumb. This is the real stuff. This is the real scary stuff. Rabbit Wise is stupid. He doesn't know what he's doing! I don't care if he made some of the most likable movies of all time! He's dumb! He's a doo-doo head! If you took poo and added even more poo, that'd be Robert Wise! He's dumb! He's so dumb! He has no idea at all! Love me! Love me! Don't love that! This is stupid! Love me! Me, love me, love me, love me! I'm the genius! I'm the groundbreaking genius! God, I lost my fucking mind there for a second. I was literally about to go out and impale Jean de Bont on a tetherball pole. All right, back to the movie. Really, Shyamalan, did you read that line out loud? Did you ever read that line out loud? You couldn't have. You clearly couldn't have. I mean, you just stated that these technologically advanced aliens, these creatures that we are supposed to be afraid of, cannot get through pantry doors. They can build spacecraft that can jump millions of miles across space, but
they seem to have trouble with pantry doors.
They can take these exact same spacecrafts and turn them invisible so that nobody else can find them, years above our technology. But
they seem to have trouble with pantry doors.
They're gonna take over our planet, but
they seem to have trouble with pantry doors.
They're going to wipe out all of mankind, but
they seem to have trouble with pantry doors.
You can't be this stupid! You can't! I mean, you literally just stated out loud why this movie can't work! I mean, what are you, a moron? I hate to borrow from a subpar comedy, but take it, Scary Movie 3!
They mastered space flight, but they can't get through a wooden door?
You see what you did there, movie? You see what you did? You just made Charlie Sheen write about something! You did that, movie! You did it! That's how bad you've gotten! This advanced technologically holy shit fuck race of aliens! Stop! Come to a halt by a fucking pen tree? Land you're in, you cannot blow in your hand and come up with a pumpkin. How did you even come to that conclusion? I mean, what's next? He's gonna blow in his hand and the beautiful woman's gonna come out? How can you blow into your hand and make a woman? Why would you even be chasing hedgehogs if you can blow into your hand and make a woman? It does not add up. My God, how do you even advertise a show like this? I mean, what did the commercials look like?
Hey kids, Ren and Stimpy making too much sense for you? Then put on The Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. You'll love this cosmic out-of-body raping of your senses. It's like a Japanese show in English, only you still have no idea what's going on. You must be at least this high to watch.
This is torture! This is madness!
This is Sonic!
Do yourself a favor and go. Just go. Click on something else. Really, you don't want to stay here. You won't survive it. I barely survived it. This movie's horrendous! It's horrendous! It's just ungodly, unnatural! If a piece of shit took a piece of shit, and that piece of shit took a piece of shit, and that piece of shit took a piece of shit, and that piece of shit took a piece of shit, and that piece of shit made a movie! And that movie took a piece of shit! This is a piece of shit, you would say! I'm
trying, movie! I'm really trying to understand you, but you just don't add up! You decapitated Macy's Day Balloon! You are shit on a dick! This movie! I mean, my God! It is horrendously bad, beyond annoying. Every second is like a kick to my ballsack. The story, the characters, everything about it is like a little kid jumping on her bed screaming. It's just loud, grating, and makes no sense. It's one of the worst, people. One of the worst I've ever had to sit through. It is a piece of... Ah! There are no words to describe it. There's only one single, solitary image. Thank you. I'm the Nostalgia Critic. Run, my children! Run, you're free! Flee this horrible cauldron of ass! Ah! Ah! Ah!
Go ahead.
This movie... Ugh. I mean, it's... Ugh. It's really... Fuck! Okay.
I apologize.
Fuck! Okay. I'm really sorry, it's just... Man, is this a bad one. I mean, just saying the title of this movie pisses me off. That's how bad it is. What?
A Troll in Central...
Fuck this movie! A Troll in Central Park!
Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it so you don't have to. As you can probably tell by my voice, I'm just getting over an illness. It was either brought on by natural circumstances or the film I saw was so bad it made me physically sick. Either one wouldn't surprise me. So, the doctor says I should be fine, though, as long as I get plenty of rest and relaxation.
Ow!
Oh, don't you know? The cure for anything, anywhere is laughter. Oh.
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Bitch Spasms, and I'm here to make you laugh. Oh.
But I don't want to laugh. I want to get better.
Well, laughter's the best medicine.
No, medicine's the best medicine.
Oh, what? You don't trust a doctor who looks like this?
No, I don't.
Look, a red nose. It's funny.
No, it isn't.
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 Ow!
Yeah, it's Patch Adams, everybody. Oh, yeah. That's a rational response, and not some contrived screenwriting device.
Ow!
Oh, you see? I connected with you.
No, you did! You hit me in the face!
Wait for it.
Ow!
You know, I'm really regretting writing this character. Holy smokes, she died in real life? That's horrible. God, can I even make a joke about that? I mean, a woman was murdered. Like, that'd probably be in bad taste, right? I mean, it's... I feel so bad about what I said earlier. I don't know what I can or can't get away with now. This is really sensitive territory. Holy shit. I gotta do more research on this. I gotta find out all the details. God, maybe she was molested. Maybe she did go through all that horrible stuff. Or maybe she was... A man! Who was not romantically interested in Patch at all. In fact, the female character was a complete work of fiction in this movie. Okay, movie. Come here. Come here, movie. Come here!
You're getting a weapon, movie! You're getting a weapon, movie! Come here! Come here! Bad movie! It's a bad movie! I'm so ashamed of you! Bad movie!
Okay, all bets are off. If this movie can't even represent a dead person by getting his gender right, not making up a false romance, and a child molesting story, all of it fabricated! I'm sorry, I've worked my way up to this joke. Remember that scene I brought up earlier?
What if a doctor becomes emotionally involved with a patient? What is wrong with that? Does a doctor explode?
Well, if you count bullets blowing up the head of your fictional dead girlfriend, yes! Yes, they fucking do!
I mean, I know a person really was murdered in real life, but it wasn't the same way, it wasn't the same time, and it wasn't even the same gender as they're saying here. And what is so strange about this is that it totally proves why the method they're so poorly trying to convey to us wouldn't work. People do make bad choices when they're emotional, and bad things do happen. Again, the real teachings of the real Hunter Adams are much smarter than this. And by trying to simplify it to such a disgusting, fictionalized degree is absolutely horrible. Let me tell you something, movie. Maybe you should have been emotionally invested when you were representing the life of a man, his theories, his friends, his real life practices, and his actual hard work. Fuck you! This is all I can do. That's all. I have no words. This is the only representation I can give. Feed on it. Feed on it. Let it fester. Let it sink into your contrived, manipulated anus. Look the guy up. Donate to his hospital if you want. Just don't believe anything in this shit. Fuck, 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 shit, fuck, 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 shit, fuck.
Ho, ho, you conformist. Don't you know that the answer to anything is...
Don't worry, he's not a reoccurring character. I'm the Nostalgia Critic, guy. Remember it so you don't have to.